my calculations are correct, when this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious shit.
With all the problems we have with the windscreen, I got a replacement, by the way, for the windscreen. But hello, welcome back to the DeLorean. With all the problems we have with the windscreen, I thought, well, let's do something a bit more simpler, this build. Yes, the windscreen needs to be replaced. Yes, I'm not finished with the build of the DeLorean itself. But I recently got the last issues from this series. So I thought, let's build the last thing from this series before I go back to the windscreen problems, which I'm going to do, as I said, off camera. Haven't done it yet, but I will do it soon, but my mind wasn't in the right mood for that. So the last four issues, 127, 128, 129 and 130, the last issue will actually be a single build, which will be the let me see if I can actually show you, which is this one thing over here. It's the plutonium suitcase Doc Brown has. It consists of four stages to build it, and here are all the parts to build it. A quick reminder, there are more issues of this series beyond issue 130. There are, I believe, about 20 or 25 additional issues, but those are to construct the 1950s wheels to the DeLorean, and the train rails to the DeLorean, and the box which comes under the hood with all the equipment Doc makes in the 1950s to make it able to travel into time. I am not going to do that. I'm going to keep the DeLorean after issue 130 as it is, from the first movie only. But let's get into the build, and the first thing we're gonna construct is, I believe, the top section of the suitcase, which is gonna be, let me get the correct issue, 127. So we have the top section over here, and the not the hinge, but the latch and the hand grip. So let's open her up. We got a lot of small parts over here. Let's screw these things together. So with issue 127 done, we have the top section of the case. Very tiny screws going in, thick, about four over here and two, that makes a total of eight tiny screws which are going in. A little bit difficult, but they're in. Looks good. Screws shouldn't be bigger than that either. So we got the hand grip over here. As you can see, it's still, you can actually carry it. And we have these latches over here on the top section of the lid. We're going to put the lid aside for now. We're going to go to issue 128, which is going to be the case itself. So let me put the lid aside. Then we have the parts for issue 128, which is in this case the case, and a number of tiny screws again. So let me get all the parts out. We got some more latches and some more hand grips and a lot of those tiny screws. Make sure that there's nothing left in the bag before I toss it. So all we need to do is screw on the hand grips on the sides, the same method as the top section over here, so the same kind of hand grip on the side. And these things have to go on the front in the right configuration, and have to go like this, and this is where the grip is going to go for the case. Let me see how this is going to work out. Not quite sure how it's going to do that, but we'll figure it out when we get to that part. But this is the complete case. Looks nice. There's not much you need to do about modifications. I don't think we need to weather this case. It looks perfect as it is. It has all the stickers and all the markings that are supposed to be there. I'm not too sure about this marker over here going over the aluminum sides of the case, but maybe that's as the original was, I'm not sure. But the same goes for the lid, by the way. We also have the markers over there. So it looks a nice addition to the car. It's not part of the car itself, but it's a nice addition. So we're going to screw in the side grips over here, and then we're going to screw in the latches. Let's do that, and more of those tiny screws. So here we have the box itself. I put in quickly the remaining screws. We might be using these, I don't know, quite sure, but we got some spare screws in. Kept them. So we got the side handles in, and we got these parts in. Issue 129 has a little bit more parts. Most of these are foam and plasticky. These will be the hinges, I believe, for the box. Yes. We're going to close up the box, by the way, and we're going to work on some of the interior of the box. Let me quickly get the parts out and make sure that I do not lose anything, because once again we have some very small parts inside these bags. Come on, let's get out. Most of these are screws. These are luckily separately bagged. We got some plastic, as I said, some foam, two straps. I'm not quite sure what kind of material this is, but we got a small hinge, some screws, and some innards. Okay, though this piece of foam has some sticky back plastic onto it, and we need to put this inside the... Oh, we need to remove this then. We're gonna need to put that inside this this case, so it goes in like so. Okay, let's remove that backing paper and insert the foam. Okay, that is in. So that's the foam, and that is the last thing we need to do for the case. We're not going to work on the lid. Before we work on the lid, we need to add straps to this part. This part is actually going to be screwed inside the lid, so we're gonna add some detail on it. So let me get this a few stages set, and then I'll pick it back up. Okay, that is in as well. So I got the straps in on this section, and I had to screw the other side of the strap onto this part. These are still loose. You have to be careful, because how you orient those two parts. You can see there's a straight line over here as well as over here, but on the other side there is a little bump. You should make see it. Can you see it? Yes, you can see it. A little bump, and this is over here as well. So you need to make sure that these two line up. By the way, screwing in black screws into a black strap into a black piece of plastic was no fun at all. The only way actually you could do it is turning it sideways so I can actually glue it like this. That was a lot better. I had to screw it in through the strap first, and then screw it into the plastic. Anyway, the next step, step 7, will be we need to make sure that the bump is over here, and we need to orient this thing like so, and then place this over here. We need to use AP screws for that. Where are those? Are these over here? Yes, here we are, the AP screws. I need to screw in not this, but this. We need to screw in this plank into the lid of the box, and then later on we're going to screw this part into the box itself. So what we're going to do now, we're going to screw in this part, and then I'll pick it back up for you before we can screw in the hinge. Okay, both in. Now the lid and the box itself are connected with these straps, but of course they need to be connected using a hinge. So we're going to close up the box, turn it around. We got the place for the hinge over here. So, oops, here's the hinge. Let's open it up. This is known as a piano hinge. At least in my country, it is known as a piano hinge. Not quite sure what this kind of hinges are called in your neck of the woods, but as I said, in my country, they're called a piano hinge. So we need to use PP screws for that. Let me pick up a screw using a magnetic screwdriver. Thank God these things are magnetic. All right, let's see if this is going to work. It is going to require 8 screws, but since these are silver onto aluminum colored piece, these will be a little bit more easier to see while I'm screwing them in. So I'm screwing in the screw on the other side right now, so the box will not keep falling open. Like so, and now we can actually screw in the rest of the screws for the hinge. Okay, it is done, the box is finished. So when you now close the box, and it's nice, the straps actually fold inward, so you can close the box. The way to open the box, you need to carefully maneuver these two pins with your fingernails backwards, so you can actually open the box. But there it is. Okay, now the next part we need to do is construct the 12, what are these? Plutonium rods over here, these tubes. We have them over here, we got some stickers, and we also have this little alarm clock, which is from the movie. Now, quick reminder, there are several mods. Mike Lane makes a complete mod for this suitcase. I'm not quite sure if he makes the entire suitcase, but I do know he makes these inserts into soft foam, and he even actually has a better version of these tubes. I may purchase these, but I don't think so, because these are not part of the car. So I can actually purchase it later if I want, but I think this is a nice add-on, but I'm not going to spend a lot of money on updating or modifying this suitcase. But what I will do, of course, I will now try to construct on camera one of these tubes. As I said, there are a total of 12. So we got instructions on how to make one, and then we need to do the other 11 by ourselves. So the first thing we need to do is to take one of these tubes over here and a top. No, there's a indentation. Yes, there is. Over here, and there's probably an indentation over there. So I think, oh, that's it. So we need to find the indentation. No glue? Apparently no. Okay, then we need to take one of these stickers. How many did they gave us? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, we got a number of stickers to spare, so that's convenient. The text is not readable, but the orientation is that this line needs to be on the bottom. On these transparent tubes. Okay, that's gonna be difficult, but let's try that. So let's remove one of these stickers. I think we can use the steam knife for that. Okay, I got it. Yes, hold on. Okay. And we need to stick it between the red and the transparent part of the tube. Okay. Okay, they're in. Well, I say they're in, but it's on. So, and now we need to put the tube we just made inside the hole, and then we're going to put in the rod into the tube, apparently. Like so? Okay, so why can't we do it this way? I have no clue why we're doing this order. But yeah, that's it. So we need to do 11 more. And we're going to do those off camera. I have here one of those tubes and one of these rods. Now, what I did was, that was not in the instructions, but I did glue on the top section of the tube, because on some of these tubes, the top section actually came loose, and it took me a while to get the bottom section of the tube out of the case. The intention is to put this tube with the sticker on top through the larger hole, and then maneuver it to the bottom hole. And some of these will stay in place, but some of these, as you can see, will slip through. So what I'm also going to do, I am going to put some glue in there. I use, by the way, I use Ravel Contactac Clear, which is also known as a cockpit glue. It is special glue for transparent parts. I certainly hope it will work for this plastic and not just for styrene, but I will glue this into place and then put it on a side so it can dry. But after that, we're gonna put all these into the case which I have over here. So they're all put in and they look okay to me. I have no complaints. Of course, it can always be done better, especially with these screw holes to be masked on, but yeah, it's okay with me. So you can just close this case, and we have here the alarm clock which Doc Brown has put on the dashboard of the DeLorean. I'm gonna glue most, if not all, of those rods inside this tube, of these tubes, and place them inside the case when finished. Some of them will fit, some of them actually are too loose, so these have to be glued. Anyway, it was a fun build, quite simple. I don't understand why they had to put it over the period of 4 complete issues. So normally you had to wait 4 weeks for the entire case to be completed. But well, that's the problem, of course, of part works. Sometimes you have a lot to do in one issue, and sometimes you have to wait an entire month to do something. But this case is finished. As a this case and this construction was actually the final issue for the build of the original car. The car is not finished yet. I will finish the car on camera, I promise. No problem with that. But as you all know, I need to replace the windscreen and do some repairs on the back. Hopefully we'll be doing this next time. I'm not quite sure when, but I am going to do it. Thank you so much for joining with me. As I said, I will finish the car, don't worry about it. But in my own time, and as soon as the windscreen has been repaired and the back has been screwed on, then I will pick it up with the camera, to complete the rest of the construction. But for now, thank you so much for joining with me. Yeah, so we'll see each other very soon. Thank you so much, and until next time, bye-bye.
B&T, custom-made models and dioramas. Ha ha, like you click and subscribe you must.